I have to admit that veterans unemployment I find a little bewildering. It's more than 10% right now. These are some of the most highly trained, disciplined individuals that I have ever met. Why do you think veterans unemployment is so high?
I think it's a combination of things. One is employers tell us that they have a hard time plugging into the network to find the veterans. That's one. Another one is employers who might not have any experience with the military themselves have a hard time equating the military occupational specialties with the needs of their workforce. And sometimes it's just ignorance.
So you're co-chairing the Call of Duty Endowment, and one of the things that you're trying to do, it's funded by Activision, is bring a businessman's perspective to the nonprofit world.
It's our duty to help those who have helped us.
He came up with this wonderful idea to incentivize people whose passion it is to find jobs for veterans. So we rate organizations that purport to find jobs for veterans. We have metrics by how well they do. And if they do well, they're incentivized by monetarily and also by more support.
One of the big problems, from what I understand, is that there are a lot of troops out there who have some psychological wounds, post-traumatic stress, and the stigma of that, anecdotally, might be preventing some employers from hiring these troops.
Yep.
How much do you think that that's a problem?
Well, I think it's a cultural thing, frankly. PTSD is a, as we discuss it now, is really a relatively near-term phenomenon. It's probably been around for a long time, but didn't have a name. Probably in World War II, they called it combat fatigue. But now it's PTSD. It has a name, it has a diagnosis, and we have treatments for it. And one way to overcome it is to talk about it, just as you've raised it, and to let employers know that the main thing to remember about veterans, the quality of these young people is astronomically high. Their skill sets are great, and there is a higher probability that if you hire a veteran that you're gonna get more productivity out of him or her, and they're probably gonna be, if they're treated well, they're probably gonna be more loyal to the whatever company they join for a longer period of time.
You're a veteran. You fought in Vietnam. You were there for the Tet Offensive, for Khe Sanh. What does that do to a person? What do memories like that, how do they affect you today?
I came away in awe of the American soldier in general, whether it be a Marine, a sailor, airman. The performance in Vietnam and in every conflict I've been involved in, humanitarian operations where the military has really represented all that's good about America and all that's good about what we value. We may not always get it completely right every time, but I know of no country that tries harder than this country does.
I can't not ask you about at least one question from your time when you were the National Security Advisor for President Obama. Without revealing any secure information, are you confident that the National Security Agency, which I know is not, it's separate and distinct from what you were in charge of, are you confident that there has been no overreach by them, that there hasn't been any excessive surveillance of both Americans and our allies?
Well, let me tell you that creating a Director of National Intelligence and harmonizing the various intelligence stovepipes that we have so that they work together, I know for a fact, has saved catastrophes in recent years in the capitals of the friends of ours who are now publicly criticizing us. But what would really be a shame is if people, friends of ours in particular, draw conclusions that are inaccurate. And there is no intelligence organization on the planet that does more good for the health and welfare and security of the planet than does the intelligence organizations of this country.
All right, General James Jones, thank you.
Thank you.
Just last week, the Call of Duty Endowment announced 7 winners for its Seal of Distinction Veteran Employer Award. The honor comes with a $30,000 grant for those businesses leading the charge in hiring vets. You can learn more about this year's recipients and how you can get involved at callofdutyendowment.org.